Assuming that you did your fourth and fifth step, we're going to turn to page 75. That's page 75, paragraph 2. Page 75, paragraph 2. What we're going to be doing in the next few minutes is going over what we need to do after we complete our fifth step. In the event that your sponsor already walked you through this, I'm going to ask that you walk through it again with the rest of us in the workshop, for those of you that were not taken through the remaining steps in this way. Okay, paragraph 2. The authors say, we pocket our pride and go to it, illuminating every twist of character, every dark cranny of the past. Once we have taken this step, withholding nothing, we are delighted. We can look the world in the eye. We can be alone at perfect peace and ease. Our fears fall from us. We begin to feel the nearness of our Creator. We may have had certain spiritual beliefs, but now we begin to have a spiritual experience. The feeling that the drink problem has disappeared will often come strongly. We feel we are on the broad highway, walking hand in hand with the Spirit of the universe. These are the fifth step promises. As we mentioned in an earlier session, that there are not 12 promises in this book. There are many, many promises. These are the fifth step promises. Here's something to consider. The authors are saying, once I've taken this step, providing I withhold nothing, I'm going to be delighted. That doesn't mean I'm excited about what I'm sharing with you in my inventory, but am I delighted about the work I'm doing? Now, if I'm not delighted, I can shut the book and stop there, because that's exactly what my first sponsor did with me. I did my first inventory. He said, are you delighted? And I said, no. And then he asked me a couple other questions. Do you feel that you can look the world in the eye? Well, no. Do I feel alone at perfect peace and ease? No. Are my fears falling from me? No. Did I begin to feel the nearness of my Creator? No. And he shut the book. He shut the book, said, that's it. I said, what do you mean that's it? We need to go on and do the other steps. He said, no. He says, it says right here, once we've taken the step with holding nothing, we are delighted. He said, you left something out. No, I didn't. Oh, yeah, you did. About 3 days later, I give him a call and I say, you know, there was this one thing. There was this one little thing that I forgot to mention. And invariably, that has been my experience with people I've taken through the steps. They get to this point, they're not delighted. It's because there's something they're still holding on to. Because the authors are telling me, look how it's worded. Withholding nothing, we are delighted. These are the promises of doing the fifth step. Now, my own experience with the inventory was this was the first, not first, but rather most impactful relationship, or rather most impactful experience I had with God. I began to have a much more impactful experience when I did my fourth step, because for the first time in my life, I was able to sit down with another human being and tell them about all the stuff that I had done, all the harm I had caused to other people, all the secrets that I had concealed. These were all the things that were blocking me from God. So you see, when I'm willing to disclose that to another person, I am going to be delighted. And I started to experience what it says in the next sentence, that I could be alone at perfect peace and ease. So consider that. If you're not delighted about what you're doing, there's probably something you're leaving out. The last sentence, it says, we feel we're on the broad highway, walking hand in hand with the Spirit of the universe. How many times have you been to meetings and heard the topic, let me hear your experience with being with the Spirit of the universe? I don't see any hands going up. It's right there in the book. They're telling us this is what we're going to experience. This isn't about knowledge. This isn't about information. This is something we're going to experience. I'm going to begin experiencing walking hand in hand with the Spirit of the universe. What's that like for you? See, if I don't have that experience, I can't transmit it. And if I haven't experienced it, I certainly can't talk about it. So if you're having an experience of walking hand in hand with the spirit of the universe, I encourage you to take that experience back to your meetings and tell people about it. Share your experience about walking hand in hand with the spirit of the universe. Now, I would have resistance when I would hear people talking about these things in meetings. And the reason I had resistance to it is because I was not having that experience. So if you share an experience that I haven't had, my mind is going to have resistance to it. Oh, that's not possible. He's not really walking hand in hand with the spirit of the universe. He's just like the rest of us. He's a drunk just like me. Well, of course. But I'm here to tell you, when we take these steps in the way that they were done in the 40s, your sobriety is going to look really different, because that's what happened to me. My sponsor took me through the steps very quickly. See, you cannot take anybody through these steps too quickly, but I'll tell you what, you can take them through too slowly. See, I'm the real alcoholic. I need to get through these steps as quickly as possible because I need to get to that power, and I need to get to it now because I need power, because I'm a real alcoholic.